Grace, delicacy, subtlety are three words rarely mentioned in close proximity to David Lee Roth, the frantic frontman of Van Halen. Roth has not exactly gone out of his way to project a refined image. Indeed, Lloyd's of London has taken out a multi-million dollar paternity policy to protect him from the consequences of any potential offstage debaucheries. But on stage, Roth is in his native element, and to him,
being on stage is great. It's like being in the jungle, and you know, you hear all the noise and the volume, and the people are all screaming, and there's smoke in the air, and people are throwing stuff up on stage. They throw, you know, scarves and brassieres and, you know, the keys to their house and the keys to their car, and everything comes up on stage. It's a big mess. It looks just like my hotel room, man. And, you know, and it gets really hot, reaches about 110 degrees Fahrenheit by about the second song, and you're out of wind, and you kind of limp, or you barely make it to the next song, you know, and that's only the second song. You feel like an animal, man. You feel like, phew, it's real primal. Has great therapeutic value, you know. I have a good time. That's why I got this job.
When David Lee Roth knocks off after a hard day's night of inciting animal passions and heads backstage, there's one thing he does not want to see. Brown M&M.
Without going into it too heavily, Van Halen does not allow brown M&Ms in the backstage area. M&Ms, Smarties, I think they call them some parts of the world. And it's in the contract. If there are brown M&Ms, then we don't play. And sometimes smart people, you know, they figure, they won't notice they put a brown M&M or two. They leave them in, you know, and you go in and you see brown M&Ms, and you have no choice left but to destroy the entire dressing room.